Well, it's official. I learned something new tonight that a lot of people have suspected. I don't know. I know what this is. I don't know what these are. I don't know why they are cast aside. I don't know if I can have them. I don't know. I just don't know what the deal is. Why are they cast aside? They're not over here with the inventory, which is scarce, by the way. She pretty much makes the lollipops to order. Yeah, you got some grape over here. You got some lemon action right here. Lemon's very popular. You got some apple, you got some pomegranate. I don't know why this little fella's cast aside. Do I just steal him? This is all just like random. It's 5:51 in the PM. I had to clean the coffee maker today, so I can't even make a coffee right now to go because I cleaned it because the clean light came on. It had to be descaled. And now the pieces are in here. Oh, Lord. And it's 5:51? Question is, how does this hat look? Clean, still got its shape. Looks pretty much the same as it did. I washed it in the dishwasher. They say you're not supposed to use a dishwashing detergent that has citric acid in it. But the detergent that I used had like sodium citrate. Is that anything near or like citric acid? I have no idea. But I did wash this on the top rack in the dishwasher with nothing else in it. And it came out fine. Ha! Go gamble. All right, first of all, it feels super naked leaving here. I feel super naked leaving here without a coffee. Coffee hand am empty. Number two, it's funny that I make this number two, even though it really doesn't affect because I have a stomach of steel. Even though I know it's a bad idea, ever since I had the Quesalupa, I think I may have said the wrong thing, the other Quesalupa, I think, from Taco Bell, I've been craving it. I really wanted that yesterday. Damn Quesalupa. Post-COVID shit right there. Sitting down inside the Taco Bell. Also post-COVID. word around the campfire is that little spot right there where the, I think it was supposed to be called the Harmon Hotel. It was supposed to be the fifth component of City Center when City Center first was being built. You got Mandarin Oriental, Veer Towers, Aria, Vidara, and that was supposed to be number five, and I think it was supposed to be the Harmon Hotel. They had like all this concrete up and everything, and then apparently something happened and they had to tear all the shit down. So apparently that piece of land has now been sold to someone who is going to put up some sort of retail, multi-level retail situation with shops and restaurants and stuff. I guess finally all this wall bullshit will come down and it'll start looking normal out here. Maybe. That's the word around the campfire. All right, so if you follow me on Twitter, you may have seen a couple nights ago, Sunday night, I believe, I went on a bit of a, well, it was only one tweet long, but rant about how shitty the Starbucks at Planet Hollywood is. And believe it or not, I actually got a response from Planet Hollywood and a response from Starbucks on Twitter. They both said, oh, we're gonna try to see if we can fix this problem. Yeah, right, they don't give a damn. But the Starbucks one actually asked me to DM them with the details. It's sort of an act of futility as far as getting that Starbucks to be better, but I did it anyway. And they ended up putting $5 on my Starbucks card to cover the shitty drink that I got at Starbucks that particular night. Unfortunately, $5 doesn't cover a coffee from Planet Hollywood Starbucks because they charge out the ass because they're a licensed store owned by the casinos, by the casino. But, hey, you know, what are you gonna do? Starbucks generally sucks ass. Maybe not as a, not from a profitability standpoint, perhaps, but from a customer experience standpoint, they used to be good. There they go, photobombing the back of the camera again. Hey, at least it was a nice little hey, and not something stupid, but still, it's the back of the camera. Do you see a lens anywhere? Back to the point. They used to suck. They used to be good, Starbucks. Now they suck ass. Customer experience in the toilet. I used the $5 to get a part of an Americano from Cosmo Starbucks. $5.20. It would be coffee break time, but because I got a coffee right off the bat from the Starbucks, not quite ready for a coffee yet, but right off the bat, one of the first few hands I was dealt in is the hand that you just saw, Queen Jack of Diamonds. I made it 15 pre-flop, and the flop was 10-9-3 with one diamond, so two overs and an open ender, right? And it checked to me, I bet 40 into 60. And I got check raised to 80. So clearly I'm calling 40 more. The guy had about 170 more behind the 80 that he put in. So I called 40 more. The turn was a five of diamonds. So now I have two overs, open ender, and the flush draw. Dude moves all in for like 170. I call. And the Queen of Hearts is the river. And he had a set of nines. But obviously, I'm just not folding that hand. Certainly not on the flop.
Unfortunately, that seems to have set the stage for the rest of the game so far. I just flopped two pair against queen five. Dude had top pair and a five kicker, and I bet the shit out of it all the way down, and he proceeded to backdoor a straight with the five. So I'm stuck nicely at the moment, and I just decided to get up and take a little walkie walk. But yeah, I'm pretty sure it's gonna turn around. I mean, we have some people in the game that really, the dude with the queen five, a dude bet 30, and the guy tried to raise $20 more. I know what you're thinking. He just slid out 50 instead of 60, right? No, he said 30, I'll raise 20 more. Well, it's official. I learned something new tonight that a lot of people have suspected, but no one's ever been able to say for sure. But live poker is rigged. It's rigged. There's just no two ways about it. No two ways about it. I went back in after taking a little breaky break and bought in for another 100, which put me in the game for 11. So I had three on the table. So I pretty promptly ran that up to about 575, and then I just got smacked several more times. And just now the dude turned a set of tens on me. Oh Lord. I raised the button with pocket jacks, flop a set, the board four flushes. I had, I forgot what the hand was that I played. But it was shitty. And I lost a pot. The very next hand I had pocket aces. Dude on my right, the one who doesn't know what's going on, limped in. And I made it 20 like quickly because I raised the pot before. So I made it 20 like kind of quickly, like in a tilty sort of fashion. And a lot of people were raising to 20 pre-flop in this game. There wasn't anything out of, you know, the norm, too far out of the norm, or it wasn't out of the norm at all. I only got one caller on my right, flopped a set of aces. He leads for $20, but it was like ace jack nine with two clubs. So I quickly raised it to 60, and he just folded like so fast. So in other words, flop a set of aces, get no action, flop top set of jacks, and the board four flushes. The last hand I played, I just played it sort of aggressively. The dude had pocket tens, I had ace, queen of clubs, king of clubs on the flop, 10 of clubs on the turn. Of course, I get it all in for like 120, and he turned a set of tens. Of course, I can never hit a draw, ever. It just doesn't happen. As I already mentioned, the preflop bets in the game were 15 to 20. Sometimes they were 25. Earlier in the game, they were 25 and 30. I could tell you like 10 bad beat stories in the game, but it's pointless. I don't want to tell bad beat stories. It's just a stupid game, minus 1100. And you know, that's like 3.5 buy-ins. It pisses me off to leave that game because if I had another 1,000 on me, I'm pretty sure that I would have a decent chance of getting back. But first of all, the goal is not to get back, but I want to get back. But the thing is I don't bring as much money with me as I used to. I guess it's an attempt to control my bankroll or something, but it makes no sense. I'm wide awake, filled with energy. I didn't even bring an ATM card, and you know I don't want to spend $13 or $17 or whatever it is to get money out of an ATM in Aria, that's for sure. It's so funny where my head is, because there was a Cosmo sign. One of the things on there just said bites. It was like listed, bites, beats, beverages. And when I first saw it, I thought, beats like bad beats. That's exactly what I thought it meant. I thought it meant food, drink, and bad beats. My brain legit thought that that's what it meant. And then I thought, what do they mean? Bites beat beverages, as if bites outranks beverages, like bites wins over beverages. And then I realized that it's obviously food, beverages, and a damn DJ or some kind of music or something. But I legit thought it meant bad beats. Like, I legit thought that. So I guess that's just where my head is. All right, let's do the bitter version of the outro. If you like my damn videos, click the damn thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe, tell your damn friends about the videos, and leave a damn comment down below. Pissed off tonight. Pissed, I tell you. See you next time.